One fine day, you press the start button of the computer and see on the black screen and the message is written. Reboot and select proper boot device or insert boot media in selected boot device and press a key. The following causes will lead to this error. Loosen the cable connecting the hard drive to the motherboard. Power is insufficient for the hard drive to function. Incorrect BIOS setting. Damaged hard drive. Main board does not support the existing hard drive standard. Okay, and now I will check each step for you to follow. First, I'll set the BIOS back to default. Open the power button of the computer and press the delete key repeatedly until the BIOS screen opens. Press F9 key to restore BIOS to default. Press the yes key to agree to restore. Use the left or right arrow keys to select yes. Press the F10 key to save and exit BIOS. Okay, so as to restore the BIOS, but the system's still error and not working. Now I will check the cable for loose or cracked and plug again. I check the cable and the plug I don't see is damaged. And I plugged it in again to test it again. It still cannot run into Windows. Now I will proceed to replace another hard drive. It still gives an error. Okay, after plugging the cable back in, it reported an invalid boot standard error. That means my hard drive is in MBR format and my BIOS on my computer is in UEFI format. There are times when the BIOS fails to change its settings. Okay, because my hard drive is still working normally and I don't want to reinstall Windows. So I'm going to the BIOS to change that. You turn off the device and then turn on the device again and press the delete key repeatedly to enter the BIOS. When you get into the BIOS, you switch to the boot tab. In the boot menu, you find the CMS. You can see I'm going to be UEFI and legacy. Now press enter to see if there are many options. If so, try changing to another option. Change and press F10 key to save and restart the computer. Okay, the machine has booted into Windows.